name's Steve Arpin. I drive the number 00 Ford Fiesta in the Red Bull Global Rallycross Series. I grew up in Fort Francis, Ontario, Canada. I've pretty much been racing since I was 10 years old, and anything with a motor that I could get my hands in or my butt in to race, I've raced. Started out racing go-karts, moved up quick to dirt modifieds, raced all around the country in dirt modifieds till I was about, oh God, till 2007, 2008. In between there, I raced snowmobiles in the wintertime. I even raced something as stupid as bathtub boats a few times. But everything I've ever raced, I've had one goal in mind, and that's to make it to the top in racing and to have a career in motorsports. And the GRC, it was kind of a natural transition. We moved up to NASCAR for a little while, and I was really looking for something new and exciting and with a younger demographic and something that's going to really get people's attention. And the GRC was really young a couple years ago, and just to see what it is today, just seeing these venues that we're at, it's the most exciting form of motorsports, and the possibilities and what this kind of racing is going to bring to our fans moving into the future is absolutely, the possibilities are endless. And it's like, there's nothing else I'd rather be doing than racing GRC. Racing these GRC cars, I can honestly tell you, after you sit in the seat of one of these things, or if you ever have an opportunity to go for a ride in one of these things, you'll quickly understand why you'll hear lots of guys saying that there is absolutely nothing in this planet that compares to driving one of these cars. The acceleration is mind-blowing. I don't think there's a car besides an NHRA drag car that'll accelerate faster. And the handling, the jumps, being able to be race on wet and asphalt and dirt and jumps and all different, any kind of condition you can imagine all in one racetrack, it's unbelievable. Racing everything growing up, I would say that there's little things from every different type of discipline I've raced that you can apply and help and just try and take little pieces from here and there and try and kind of bundle them all together to help you in this. But the biggest thing is just being able to race snowmobiles and a little bit of dirt bikes and dirt cars and NASCAR and all the different things. Is it really teaches you just the art of racing and how to be aggressive, how to pass people, how to kind of read what the other guys are doing or read what the different track conditions are going to be doing, really understand the fastest way to get around a track and put all those into one little fluent motion, if you want to call it that, to try and make the best laps you can consistently. Dirt racing growing up, I think the biggest thing that ever taught me was car control. And I kind of got myself in a lot of situations last year where I probably should have wrecked. I did a couple times, so I can't say it got me right out of it, but there's lots of situations where you get yourself into just a bad spot where you have the ability to drive out of it just because you have that added car control from being sliding around a dirt track your whole life. I know one of the most common things that I hear from fans is they just love the popping and banging, and it creates so much anticipation at that starting line. And I always kind of giggle to myself because it's like, if you guys had any idea how much worse that is sitting in the driver's seat, it's like when those red lights start flashing, we start hearing that popping and banging, the cars are squatting and getting gripped up from our launch systems being engaged, and you're sitting there just trying to think about, like, how on earth am I going to make it through that first corner? Because my whole race depends on it. It's like my heart, I can honestly feel like jumping out of my chest when those start lights are going. The way these cars just absolutely, you can have your seatbelts as tight as possible. And when we let go of that launch button and we take off, like it's 0 to 60 like that. And it literally, even if your seatbelts are tight, you're pushed back in your seat so hard that everything's loose. And it's like, you're getting down to that first corner, cars are switching lanes, cars are doing everything. Some cars will spin their tires a little bit. You gotta make really fast decisions to get around them and not try and rear end them, because they're only starting like 10 feet ahead of you if you're on the second or third row. And then getting down to that first corner, it is, I was gonna say controlled chaos, but it's not even controlled chaos. It's just pure and absolute chaos getting down into that first corner. And if you can make it through there, it's the biggest sigh of relief. And it's like, as a driver, one of the hardest things is just kind of collecting yourself again and getting yourself calmed back down. It's like, all right, now we got to focus. We got to race. We got to hit our marks, be smooth, consistent, and make this thing to the finish. This is going to be my second year in the GRC. And honestly, the first year, it was such a learning year for me. I really managed my expectations and what my goals were. And honestly, having an off season to really dissect and go through and really digest everything I learned last year, I think is going to be crucial for me. Going into 2014, I'm really going to try and take all the mistakes I made in that book of mistakes that's like probably about that thick, and just try and push that aside and really focus on all the things we learned and did right, and really try and put all those together to have really consistent finishes all year long. My goal for the end of the year this year is when we get to Vegas for the season finale, I want to have a shot, if not leading the points going into it, I want to definitely be in a position to have a shot at that championship. This Royal Purple Ford Fiesta I'm driving, it's an incredible piece of equipment, and we definitely have all the people in place and resources in place to be able to make that happen. So that's definitely my goals for this year. But honestly, one of the most exciting things about this year is just being a part of this. It's a young series, the Red Bull Global Rallycross Series, it's a young series. But being a part and seeing how fast this is growing and the venues we're going to this year, our new TV package with NBC is an incredible opportunity for all of us. And it really puts this series in the forefront where it needs to be. It's talking about the excitement at the starting line, talking about how it just keeps your heart racing. It's the form of racing that keeps your attention, like it keeps you sitting on the edge of the seat all the time. I know when I DVR my race at home and go back and watch it, I'm like antsy watching it, and it's even the races that I'm not in, I'm watching all the heat races and everything, and it's so much fun. So to be a part of the series, it's honestly 2014 is just a small glimpse of what the future holds for the Red Bull Global Rallycross Series, and it's honestly just so exciting to be a part of it as it grows.